Sutra. Good knowing advisors, Mahaprana Paramita is the most honored, the most supreme, the foremost. It does not stay, it does not come or go. All Buddhas of the three Bodhas of time emerge from it. They should use great wisdom to destroy affliction, defilement, and the five skandhic heaps. With such cultivation as that, you will certainly realize the Buddha way, transforming the three poisons into morality, concentration, and wisdom. Commentary, the great master again addressed the assembly, saying, in the self nature of each of you, there is limitless wisdom. Mahaprana Paramita is originally fully present within your self nature. You need not seek it outside. It does not stay, it does not come or go. The prana wisdom of your self nature is unattached. All Buddhas of the three Buddhas of time, the past, present, and future, issue from Mahaprana Paramita, the highest, most supreme, most honored, number one Dharma. You should use this great wisdom, not small wisdom, to destroy affliction, defilement, and the five skandhic heaps of form, feelings, perceptions, impulses, and consciousness. Without prana, you cannot see that the five heaps are empty, and therefore you have affliction and are unable to cut off defilement. If you wish to have genuine prana, you must illumine and view the five skandhas all as empty, as Avalokiteshvara did when deeply practicing the prana paramita. Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva worked a long time practicing the deep prana paramita. He could not, in just a short time, illumine and view the five heaps as empty. If you practiced the deep prana paramita, you can see the five heaps in this way, and when you destroy all affliction and attachment to sense objects, the original prana nature manifests itself. With such cultivation as that, you will certainly realize the Buddha way, transforming the three poisons into morality, concentration, and wisdom. There is no doubt that you will realize the way, turning greed, hatred, and stupidity into morality, concentration, and wisdom. Let's see whether or not you can change. If you change, you will dwell in prana. If you do not change, you will wander among the deluded. Sutra, good knowing advisors, my Dharma door produces 84,000 wisdoms from the one prana. Why? Because worldly people have 84,000 kinds of defilement. In the absence of defilement, wisdom is always present, since it is not separate from the self nature. Understand this. Understand that this Dharma is just no thought, no remembrance, non-attachment, and the non-production of falsehood and error. If shown through suchness nature and by means of wisdom, contemplate and illuminate all Dharmas without grasping or rejecting them. That is to see one's own nature and realize the Buddha way. Good knowing advisors, if you wish to enter the extremely deep prana realm and the prana samadhi, you must cultivate the practice of prana, hold and recite the Diamond Prana Sutra, and that way you will see your own nature. Commentary, the sixth patriarch said, from one kind of wisdom, measureless pranas are produced. These 84,000 kinds of wisdom are just 84,000 kinds of prana. If you change the defilements of external objects, it becomes wisdom. Do not use your discriminating consciousness to contemplate and illuminate all dharmas. Use wisdom. If you wish to enter the sutra store and have wisdom like the sea, if you wish to master all dharmas and prana samadhi, you must cultivate the prana conduct. How do you practice the prana dharma door? Hold and recite the Diamond Prana Sutra. Because the sixth patriarch became enlightened upon hearing the Diamond Sutra, he tells everyone, you should all recite the Diamond Sutra, Hold it in your mind. Do not be distracted or forgetful. Hold the Diamond Sutra and you will see your nature. In reciting sutras, it is essential to avoid giving rise to false thinking and extraneous thoughts. Once there was a man who recited the Diamond Sutra every day. One night he dreamt that a ghost asked him to take him across to a more favorable rebirth, just as we reform the Ulambana ceremony on the 15th day of the 7th month in order to take across parents from these and past lives. The god said, "Please recite a sutra to take me across." "How many times shall I recite it?" the man asked. The god said, "One recitation will be enough." The next day, halfway through the recitation, one of the man's servants brought him a cup of tea. He pushed the cup aside, thinking, "I do not want it," and continued to recite. That evening, the ghost returned. "You promised to recite the sutra for me," he said, "but you only recited half of it. What do you mean?" The man replied, "I recited the whole sutra." The ghost said, "You recited the whole sutra, but halfway through you thought, 'I do not want it.' So the merit from the second half of the recitation was lost." The man then realized what happened. "Yes," he replied, "I did think, 'Do not want,' but it was tea I did not want, not the sutra's merit. It took only this was 'I do not want' halfway through the recitation to convince the ghosts and spirits that he did not want the merit. Probably the ghosts took the merit for themselves." The man said, "I will recite it again." This time he recited without interruption, and the next evening the ghost happily bowed to him in thanks for the compassionate recitation. So when you recite the Diamond Sutra, do not think, "I do not want," reciting "Sabuti, Sabuti, I don't want Sabuti." Sabuti will probably run away. Sutra. You should know that the merit and virtue of this sutra is immeasurable, unbounded, and indescribable, as the sutra text itself clearly states. This Dharma door is the superior vehicle taught for people of great wisdom and superior faculties. When people of limited faculties and wisdom hear it, their minds give rise to doubt. Why is that? Take, for example, the rain which the heavenly dragons shower on Jambudvipa. Cities and villages drift about in the flood like thorns and leaves. But if the rain falls on the great sea, its waters neither increase nor decrease. If people of the great vehicle, the most superior vehicle, hear the Diamond Sutra, their minds open up, awaken, and understand. They then know that their original nature itself possesses the wisdom of Prana. Because they themselves use this wisdom constantly to contemplate and illuminate, they do not rely on written words. Take, for example, the rainwater. It does not come from the sky. The truth is that the dragons cause it to fall in order that all living beings, all plants and trees, all those with feeling and those without feeling may receive its moisture. In 100 streams, it flows into the great sea and there unites in one substance. The wisdom of the prana of the original nature of living beings acts the same way. Commentary. People without gurus say, "The Diamond Sutra is meaningless. What good points does reciting it have? If you recite it every day, can you go without eating and still live? Keep reciting and we will see if you can go without eating." People of shallow roots and wisdom do not believe in this sutra. The Great Sea represents people of great roots and energy. As soon as they hear this Dharma, they realize that prana is originally complete within the self nature, and so they believe it. People of small roots and wisdom, however, are like grass and leaves which float on the surface of the water and sink as soon as it rains. They doubt the great vehicle Dharma, reflecting within it is not necessary for those of great wisdom to be highly literate in order to understand prana wisdom. The prana wisdom of the self nature of living beings is just like the rain from the heavens which flows into the great sea. The sea represents our inherent wisdom. No matter how much rain falls, the sea neither increases nor decreases. The Buddha Dharma is like a great sea. Only those with faith can enter. It may also be said, only those with wisdom can enter. Because without wisdom, it is difficult to enter this sea. Sutra, good knowing advisors, when people of limited faculties hear this sudden teaching, they are like the plants and trees with shallow roots which, washed away by the great rain, are unable to grow. But at the same time, the prana wisdom which people of limited faculties possess is fundamentally no different from the prana that men of great wisdom possess. Hearing this Dharma, why do they not become enlightened? It is because the obstacle of their deviant views is a formidable one, and the root of their afflictions is deep. It is like when thick clouds cover the sun, if the wind does not blow, the sunlight will not be visible. Prana wisdom is itself neither great nor small. Living beings differ because their own minds are either confused or enlightened. Those of confused mind look outwardly to cultivate in search of the Buddha. Not having awakened to their self nature yet, they have small roots. When you become enlightened to the sudden teaching, you do not grasp on to the cultivation of external things. When your own mind constantly gives rise to right views, afflictions and defilements can never stain you. That is what is meant by seeing your own nature. Commentary: deluded people do not become enlightened because their deviant views are too strong and too formidable an obstruction and cause them to disbelieve. Their ignorance is great and they give rise to much affliction, which is like thick clouds covering the sun. The sunlight is simply the prana of your self-nature, and the clouds are your deviant views and afflictions. If no wind blows the clouds away, the sunlight will not shine through. Some living beings are heavily afflicted by bad habits. Having created a great deal of bad karma, they are confused. Those with fewer bad habits and lighter karma can become enlightened. The confused person seeks the Dharma outside his own mind. Seeking outwardly, he does not recognize the originally complete Buddha of his own self-nature. The more he seeks the Buddha outside, the farther away he goes. You should enlighten yourself and not seek outside. If you hear the sudden teaching, you may become enlightened right away. Understand the prana of your own nature and always hold to right knowledge and vision. You will then be without affliction or defilement. Sutra, good knowing advisors, the ability to cultivate the conduct of not drawing inwardly or outwardly, of coming and going freely, of casting away the grasping mind, and of unobstructed penetration is basically no different from the Prana Sutra. Commentary: inside there is no body and mind, outside there is no world, but this is not dull emptiness. It is not to say my body and mind do not exist, the world does not exist, and then to fall into vacuity. What is spoken of here is non-attachment, non-attachment to the body, to the mind, and to the world. Then you may come and go freely, coming here, going there, coming back to the body and mind, going out into the Dharma realm, and you are free if you are unattached to the coming and the going. If you are attached, you are in bondage. Unattached, You are free with respect to life and death. If I want to live, I live. If I want to die, I die. You ask, is this suicide? No, you need simply sit down, enter Dhyana Samadhi and go. You need not take poison to make sure that you will die. Isn't this freedom? If it were not freedom, you would not be able to go. How was the third patriarch, Sun Tzu, able to reach up and grasp the limb of a tree and while hanging there, die? How could he enter Nirvana in this way? He could do this because he was free to live or die, free to come or go. If I wish to live, then I may never die. If I wish to die, I die right now. This is what is meant by coming and going freely. If you are free to come and go, you can end your life even while in the midst of talking, just like the great master Tao Sheng. It was really a good spot. The first part of the Mahaparinirvana Sutra said that the Chantikas, those of little faith, do not possess the Buddha nature, but Tao Sheng disagreed. I say that Ichitikas do have Buddha nature. Everyone said he's crazy, he's mentally ill, he knows what the sutra says, yet he deliberately contradicts it. They scolded him, they shunned him. Get out of here, they said. Master Tao Sheng then made a vow. He said, if my explanation of Dharma is in agreement with the Buddha sutras and the Buddha's mind, then in the future I shall end my life while lecturing from the Dharma seed. But if I have spoken contrary to the Buddha's mind, this vow will not be fulfilled. He then went to the mountains and lectured on sutras to the rocks and dragged boulders. When the rocks heard him, they nodded their heads in acceptance of his principles. When Sheng the Venerable spoke the Dharma, even the rocks bowed. He continued to lecture on sutras until once when mysteriously and wonderfully he paused while lecturing and died sitting in the Dharma seat. The assembly looked up and cried, he has gone to rebirth. Wasn't he a good sport? This is what is meant by coming and going freely. You say, Dharma Master, I quite agree with you. I don't want to be attacked. In fact, I don't want to follow the rules. After all, the rules are just an attachment. Wrong. If you can cast away your grasping mind and be unattached, you should be unattached to what is wrong. But you should not be unattached to what is right. For example, if you follow the rules, you can become a Buddha. But if you think, I am not attached, I don't have to follow the rules, then you cannot become a Buddha. Go down the right road, retreat from the wrong one. Do not become attached to principles which are in opposition to the way, but grasp and hold tightly to those principles which are in accord with it. Holding to and reciting may be an attachment, but holding to and reciting the Dhamma Sutra is cultivation. Do not say, I am attached, I have a small fault which I do not want to give up. What is more, I do not want anyone to know about it. That is to be even more attached. All right then, you say, I don't care if anyone knows about it. If people say I'm wrong, I will be unattached and pay no attention. That is Dhyan knowledge and Dhyan views. The more you cultivate that way, the further you drift from the Buddha Dharma. Once you have left attachments behind, you can penetrate and understand without obstruction and be without obstacles to your progress. The ability to cultivate this conduct is basically no different from the Prana Sutra. If you cannot cultivate this conduct, you will be in opposition to the principle of the Dhamma Sutra. But if you can cultivate, it is Prana Wisdom Manifest. Sutra, good knowing advisors. All sutras and writings of the great and small vehicles The 12 divisions of sutras have been devised because of pupil and established because of the nature of wisdom. If there were no pupil, the 10,000 dharmas would not exist. Therefore, you should know that all dharmas are originally postulated because of pupil, and all sutras are spoken for their sakes. Commentary on the higher plane. The sutra tallies with the principles of all Buddhas, and below, it tallies with the opportunities for teaching living beings. For that reason, the word sutra took on the meaning to tally. The 12 divisions of sutra text are prose, verse, transmitting of predictions, interpolations, the speaking of Dharma without its having been requested, discussion of causes and conditions, analogies, events of the past lives of the Buddhas, events of the past lives of the Bodhisattvas and disciples, writing which explain principle in an especially expansive way, Dharma which has never been spoken before, and commentaries. Sutras exist because people exist. If there were no people, the sutras would be useless. In the same way, troubles exist only because there are people to help them. The Dharma teaches people how to end their troubles, to get rid of the 84,000 kinds of defilement and trouble. The Buddha teaches 84,000 Dharma doors, but if there were no people, the troubles would never have arisen. The Buddha spoke all Dharmas for the minds of human beings. If there were no minds, of what use would Dharmas be?